Dear friends, welcome to another episode today in the military world. In this video, we will talk about the flight of Cerberus, the first flight of the new stealth bomber B-21 Raider from the United States Air Force. In ancient Greek mythology, Hades reigns over the world of the dead, a vast realm where souls that enter can no longer leave. To ensure this, the gates of Hades' realm are guarded by Cerberus, a gigantic three-headed dog with a serpent's tail, and its body covered in poisonous snakes. Souls, as they approach the gates of the underworld, encounter a docile and friendly Cerberus, but as soon as they enter, it transforms, preventing with all its fury that the soul returns to the world of the living. And it was this name, Cerberus, that the United States Air Force chose to christen its first bomber, the B-21 Raider, the newest stealth aircraft that promises to replace the B-2 Spearhead and the B-1B Lancer in the future. Cerberus took its inaugural flight this Friday, November 10th, taking off at 6:51 a.m. from the Northrop factory in Palmdale, California. Despite the flight not being announced in advance, dozens of enthusiasts were strategically positioned on a nearby road, resulting in many photos and videos that showed the B-21 from angles not seen before. Hours later, the United States Air Force released a statement saying that the bomber was undergoing tests by the 41st Test Wing, a detachment of the Air Force responsible for testing new American aircraft. Recently, the B-21 had been seen conducting a series of tests on the ground, such as taxiing on the runway, a procedure recognized as a prelude to an imminent test flight, leading many enthusiasts to camp in Palmdale, an effort that paid off this Friday with Cerberus's first flight. Among several photos and videos, what did we discover about the new stealth bomber from the United States Air Force? Just to provide context, the B-21 is the fifth stealth aircraft developed by the United States, with the first being the F-117 in the early 80s, followed by the B-2 Spirit in 1997, the F-22 Raptor in 2005, and finally the F-35, officially introduced in 2016. The design of the B-21 is very similar to that of the B-2, both representing a flying wing design. Flying wings began to gain prominence during World War II, with the Germans designing the Horton Ho 229 and the United States the Northrop YB-35. None of them entered full production and operation, but interest in this design resurged in the 80s, with Northrop engineers seeing great potential for stealth flight in the flying wing design. As the profile of a flying wing is much cleaner than that of an aircraft with a more traditional design, and the flying wing eliminates elements like a vertical stabilizer, it results in an aircraft much more discreet to radar, with fewer flat surfaces to reflect radar waves. The B-2 was the first flying wing aircraft to enter operation, incorporating, in addition to this more discreet design, highly advanced stealth technology such as materials for absorbing electromagnetic waves, and a wide range of electronic warfare technologies that actively affect enemy systems for target detection and tracking. According to the United States, the result was the aircraft with the highest level of stealth in the world, an effort that came at a cost, with each B-2 bomber costing around $1 billion. In addition to the exorbitant manufacturing cost, the operating cost is also very high, with each flight hour costing $65,000. Despite the B-2 having no competition in the world, with no other country even coming close in technological terms, the high maintenance and operating costs, along with the emergence of new stealth technologies, led the United States to advance with the program for its successor, a program that began in 2015. With the first flight taking place 8 years late. Regarding Cerberus, the aircraft was seen with a drag chute on its rear, used for speed, drag, and aerodynamic measurements. On its front, it came equipped with a probe for tests and data collection during flight, equipment that will obviously be removed after the end of the test phase. The photos also revealed that the B-21 is entirely rounded, even more so than the B-2, a design feature that greatly aids in stealth. Small horns were also seen next to the central fuselage, which are nothing more than auxiliary air intakes for the engines. Speaking of engines, the main air intakes are much more discreet than those of the B-2, a feature that also contributes significantly to stealth. Regarding bomb bays, they are much smaller than those of the B-2, and in fact, the B-21 will have less than half the bomb carrying capacity of the B-2. The photos raise more questions than clarifications about the types of bombs and missiles the new bomber will be able to carry. But we know that the B-21 will be able to drop free-fall nuclear bombs like the B-61. As for the engine exhausts, they are likewise more discreet than the intakes, raising questions about the number of engines on the bomb. The B-2 has 4 engines, something that is evident when observing its nacelles, but the nacelles of the B-21 are considerably smaller, indicating that the bomber is either equipped with smaller engines or has only 2. Through the observation of Cerberus, it is evident that the United States Air Force aims for a smaller, more compact, and cost-effective bomber, prioritizing stealth over the capacity for bomb transportation. Despite being in flight, many mysteries and secrets still surround what promises to be the world's most lethal and modern aircraft.